In this video, we are going to see about the different addressing modes. So what do you mean by addressing modes? Given an instruction, how it accesses the memory, that is how it accesses the data in the memory as well as the data in the register. That is what addressing modes. Okay, for any arithmetic operations or logical operations, say for example, if you take addition of two registers, for that also, it has to take the values from A and B. If it is going to take data from memory and from registers, for that also, it has to refer the memory and the particular register. Okay, so for example, add A comma M, where M indicates memory. So in that case, it has to mention the memory location. A means add, A means the data present in the accumulator. So add A comma M means add the content of accumulator and memory. For example, add this. Add A comma M means M is some memory location. Okay. Say for example this. Say let us take some. The memory location is 5. So if M is pointing this, then take the information present here and then the value in the accumulator. So after the execution of this, accumulator will consist of the added value of A plus the content of memory. That is the meaning. So in both cases, whether it is referring a memory or A, it indicates the data has to be taken from the register A and the memory location. So there are many instructions like that, and how you can address this memory location, whether the memory location, the data is present here itself or data is present somewhere else. Same way data is present in the registers, or say that we have already seen some instructions of this type, add I, B, then some data. MBA, let us take move immediate B comma 0 5, which means the data is present here itself instead in some registers or instead of the memory location. The data is present in the instruction itself. So likewise, how the data is represented, from where the instruction will take the data for its operation. Here it takes the data present in the instruction itself. Here, in another, say for example, move. Okay. R comma M means, the R is any registers, A, B, etc. So move R comma M means it is pointing to the memory location. The data will be taken from the memory, and then the data is moved to the register mentioned. So here it is different. The location is different. So addressing modes are nothing but indicating from where the data has to be taken and how it will be handled. That's where the addressing mode comes. Okay, the operation field. So for that, the operation field specified, just now we have seen MBI or move. Those things are said to be opcode of an instruction format. So the operation field of an instruction specifies the operation to be performed. What operation, move, add, sub, etc. This operation must be performed on some data stored in the computer. That's what we have seen. So for example, if it is move, this is an operation. Move, what has to be moved? Move A comma B means the value which is present in B is copied to A. It is not actually moved. A copy of B is placed in A. So after execution of the statement, B will consist of the same data. Okay, it will not be erased. So the operation must be performed on some data stored in computer registers or memory bus. The operands. Operands, now this is the operands and this is the opcode. Opcode is saying what operation has to be done, and operand is nothing but on which this operation will be done. Okay, so the operands are chosen based on addressing mode of instruction. So what is addressing? Just now I said whether you are accessing from memory or from registers, or the data is present in the instruction itself. So mainly this addressing mode is mainly for giving versatility programming to the user by providing facilities like pointers to memory. When I say what is pointers to memory, here move A comma M means it is pointing to the memory. So giving pointers to the memory. Counters, you can use counter for loop and indexing of data and program relocation. You'll see this one by one. To reduce the number of bits in the addressing fields of the instruction. For that also it is used. Let's see. Instruction cycle, the next concept, instruction cycle. Before moving to the addressing mode, we will see about the instruction cycles. What is instruction cycle? We have seen that the data has, suppose we have an instruction, move, A comma, yeah. This is kept in the main memory. Okay, this is kept in the main memory. Now, this instruction will be, previous instruction is executed. When previous instruction is executed, the program counter will point to the this memory location. Okay, when this is executed, the program counter will point to the next one. Because when this is being executed, PC, program counter will always point to the address of the next instruction to be executed in order to maintain the sequence of execution of the program. So it is automatically incremented. There is no explicit statement called PC equal to PC plus one. When this is executed, automatically program counter is pointing to the next instruction. It will be incremented, which means it is pointing to the next instruction in the memory cycle. Suppose this is 5, the memory location is 5. When this is being executed, the memory location will be 6. Now program counter will have the value 6, which means it is pointing to the next memory location. So once this is over, the data from here will be read from the memory and it is placed in the database. This is an instruction. So it is placed in the database. So address, initially the address is placed, the value of 6. The address is placed on the address bus. We have seen from A0 to A15, we have the address bus. So if it is going to be read, RD bar will be enabled. And then the data placed here is nothing but the address, which is present in the program counter. So once the read signal is sent and it is stabilized, now the data from here, it will find the respective address and the data present, which is nothing but we call it as data, but here the instructions will be there. Both are same, the instruction and data. Let us say it as an instruction for better understanding. The instruction here will be taken and placed on the database, which is nothing but from A0 to A7. These bits are the same, lines are act as database. That is why from data address movement is from CPU to this. Okay. Whereas data is, it can be moved from here to CPU as well as from CPU to here. Because now it is reading, so here it is moved. The data is, data movement is from here to database. Whereas when it is writing, let us imagine it is writing something, some data into the main memory, means write signal will be enabled and the data in the data, the address is slashed in which place it has to be returned. That will be also provided by the program counter or some other registers. And then the data which is present in A0 to A7 will be returned into the main memory. This is the process. So a program consists of series of instructions. Suppose I'm doing some factorial. So in order to achieve the factorial, or let us take the addition of two numbers. Okay, addition of two numbers, for that we have written code in a 6 consecutive places. Let us say some 8 lines are there. All the 8 lines are kept one after other, right? The program consists, that is what here means, a program consists of series of instructions. This will be stored in main memory. As I said, this will be stored in main memory. And each instruction will be read from memory. Each one by one, it will be read depending upon the program, because the program counter, when it is executing, it is pointing to that. When it is being executed, it points to the next in order to keep the sequence of execution. And we'll go through the following major phases. What will be the following? fetch the instruction from memory. Fetching means taking. Okay, reading from memory. Reading from memory. Then after reading, what will happen? It will be placed in database, which in turn will be sent to the instruction register, which we have seen while we are studying in architecture. It is microprocessor architecture, where in instruction decoder, it will decode the instruction. What is decoding? What is set in the opcode? This is opcode and these are all operand. What is set in the opcode? Move. It is movement. So now after reading this, if you understand that there will be two arguments follow. That is two opcode. So now operand. Now these two operands also will be read and then it will do what is set in that. That is what the execute instruction. So any instruction cycle will consist of the three major phases. One is fetching the information from the memory, then understanding what is said in that, and then executing what is said in that. The above steps are repeated for each and every instruction until it reaches a halt condition. And this is always called as instruction cycle. Okay, now this is just a pictorial representation. Fetch instruction, then decode, read address from memory, and then finally execute the instruction. Now, the role of the program content that just now we have seen. The program content always points to the instruction to be executed next. So there is a register called program counter or PC, which keeps track of the instructions in the program stored in the memory. PC holds the address of the instruction to be executed next and is incremented each time an instruction is pressed on it. So when you fetch the first instruction, program counter will be incremented to the next. Now it is pointing to the next instruction in the memory. Step 2. The decoding step 2 determines operation to be performed. The addressing mode of instruction and the location of the operands. What is meant by addressing mode? We'll see in short. The CPU then executes the instruction and returns to step 1 to fetch the next instruction in sequence. On the same thing, I have written, so just I'll read out, fetch the instruction. The next instruction is fetched from memory that is pointed by PC and stored in the instruction register. Now that will be fetched based in the database, which in turn will be placed in IR. Then decode instruction. During this cycle, the encoded instruction present in the IR is interpreted by the decoder. Then read the effective address. So what do you mean by read the effective address? Whether, say for example, if it is move, A comma B means it is just the data is moved between only from B register to A. So all are hardware registered. Suppose it is move A comma M means it has to do some more work. What is it? For this memory, the memory address is always present in, mostly present in HL. Okay. So when it refers M, now it has to go to H and L. Some more work has to be done by this move A comma M. So it has to go to HL, where the HL will have, HL is now act as a 16-bit register. This is 8-bit and this is 8-bit. And we know memory is a 16-bit address. Okay, so the address is present here. So whatever the address here, it goes there and then take that value, which is present there. Say for example, if it is 45, imagine. So that value is moved from, that is copied to accumulator. So after the execution of this statement, accumulator will consist of the value 45, where the 45 is present in the memory, whose location is present in HL. So this work has to be done. This is what read the effective address, whether it is A comma B or A comma M, or whether the data is present in the instruction set. Just now we have seen as MVI. MVI. This MVI. B comma 45 means instead of memory here. B comma 45 means the data is present here itself. The data is moved to B. That is a copy is made in B. So we have to decide what type of, depending upon the instruction, it has to decide from where the data has to be fetched, whether it is from direct memory or indirect memory location. We'll see what is direct memory and indirect memory. Then execute the instruction. Once it is understood, the effective address is also formed. Now it has to execute. Whatever is said in this, the movement of the copying of 45 to B or copying of fetching the data, it points to the HL, and from there it takes the memory location, it goes there, take the data stored in that and move to A, or here B to A. So all these things are done depending upon the instruction. So the control unit of the CPU passes the decoded information as a sequence of control signals to the relevant function units of the CPU to perform the actions required by the instruction. So at the beginning of this fetch cycle, we'll see this is a small example. At the beginning of the fetch cycle, the address of the next instruction to be executed is in the program counter. So let us take MAR, memory address register, memory, this is MBR, and program counter is having the value, this is instruction register and accumulator, beginning. The address in the program counter is, the address in the program counter is moved to the memory address register. And this is the only register which is connected to the address lines of the system bus. Okay. So now after the execution, the address in program counter is moved to MAR. Here, select that. Then, step two, the address in MAR is placed in the address bus. After this, this will be placed in the address lines, that is A0 to A16. This data is placed, this line. The read signal is raised because now it is going to read it from the memory. So, read signal is raised in the control bus. Result appears in the data bus and copied into memory buffer register. So, this is a buffer register where it keeps the data from read from the memory. Okay, program counter is incremented and pointing to the next. See here, it is incremented and pointing to the next memory location. The content of MBR is moved to the instruction register like that. This is MBR. Now it is moved here, and then from here it will be decoded. So if you say this, some more representation, fetch cycle. Let us say program counter is having the value 0002. It is nothing but now it is pointing this. This is our memory. Here and here all instructions are there. Now we'll concentrate on the current reading. So now it is PC is pointing this. It is nothing but move accumulator the value 0. That is the meaning of this. So after this, the accumulator must consist of 0. Right? Now, this instruction is decoded by the instruction decoder processor. All the bits of the instruction and the execution stored in IR are analyzed and decoded in the third cycle. Here, this is execution unit, decode unit, and IR. So what happens? This data, once it is read, it will be read and placed in IR. Okay. Then decoding, it will be passed to the decoding unit, where it will be decoded. It is what is said in a particular instruction. Then execution. After that, see, accumulator will consist of the value 0. Now this is the execution unit.